most common object on campus is probably a computer. Over 14,000 students and a couple thousand faculty, every single person here on campus has one. And when we talk about saving energy, the best way to do it is probably to go to the most common object and the most common energy product that we use. One thing that a lot of people on campus here do is use very big, heavy programs that run on their computer. While they do that, the programs slow down the computer for different reasons. Because of the programs, the computer uses more electricity than other programs on campus. Another problem on campus is internet. Everybody wants faster internet all the time. Everybody is connected all the time. And we think that we have a way to take both of those issues and solve the problem for everybody together.
We conducted a market survey of 300 students in order to understand where electricity consumption takes place the maximum on campus. We realized that in areas such as a library, computer labs, and hostel rooms, electricity consumption takes place the maximum due to devices such as laptops, desktops, tablets, and smartphones. And we decided to narrow down our approach to problems that occur due to electricity consumption due to these devices on campus. We then asked customers where electricity consumption takes place maximum on their devices. Majority of the customers said that playing huge games and running large software on their devices resulted in maximum electricity consumption, along with regular charging, which also contributed towards this. Let us now look at a few customer interviews that we held.
I think power is consumed excessively when devices such as laptops, desktop computers, mobiles, tablets are charged continuously in computer labs, in our library, as well as in our hostels.
So I'm guessing there are a lot of people who play lots of computer games and all, so because of that I think power consumption might increase. People who are developers, you know, developing applications for which they need all these IDs and all, which use up a lot of RAM in the systems, and probably because of that the power consumption increases.
Based on the customer interviews and the market surveys we held, we generated the following customer voices, which are very similar to the customer needs we discussed earlier. We now move on to the functional requirements that were generated using these customer voices.
Based on those customer needs that we just assessed, we came up with 7 corresponding functional requirements.
We now move on to QFD.
We found the relationship between customer voices and functional requirements and correlation between functional requirements in order to prioritize our components. We realized that utilizing the idle resources of other devices and optimizing the speed by sharing computation across the devices would be the key features for our program.
We built a Kano model based on the functional requirements that were generated during the customer interviews and market survey we conducted. In terms of excitement features, we found that customers were extremely excited about 2 specific things. One, that the capability of their device would no longer be restricted to the specifications of their device, and 2, that users would be able to gain points that could be redeemed towards high-speed internet when their device was being used for shared computation.
I think the fact that all the computation is not going to happen on my machine, on my laptop anymore, and will be distributed excites me the most, because I'm not going to face any more problems of overheating or crashing off my computer and all that. So I think that's a really cool solution.
Now for the demo of SharePal, Shared Processor Allocation across LAN. This demo involves Philip the Gamer, who's playing Mortal Kombat and has exceeded his processor's threshold clock speed, Anirudh the tablet user, Neil the movie watcher, and Kostav the smartphone user. Anirudh, Neil, and Kostav have sufficient processor resources until they reach a threshold limit, after which power consumption increases 2 to 3-fold. Our idea involves distributing Philip's processor computation across the LAN to other devices in order to bring his below the threshold limit and hence reduce electricity usage. Computation gets distributed, his clock speed reduces below the threshold and hence power consumption decreases 2 to 3-fold. Anirudh gains 15 points because 15% of the computation was done on his tablet. He can use these points to get ultra-high-speed internet for a limited period of time. Similarly, Neil and Kostov get 25 and 10 points respectively, which they can also use to get high-speed internet. The clock speed of Anirudh, Neil and Kostov increase but always remain below the threshold. This is known as underclocking and drastically reduces the power consumption.